heading out on another adventure. Flying Fish TV, Captain Fraser heading to Brazil with the family. It's going to be an exciting one.
We're heading to the pesca party, or the peida fish. It's real popular here in Brazil. Lots of food, lots of entertaining going on. Basically a family trip here, but making the most of it. We packed the travel rod. But small rod and reel. We packed the travel rod there. And Pam was clearly working hard on trying to find us one that was open. Usually most of them are open on the weekends only. Here's Tuesday. So we're trying to find one. Oh, Fraser, he is a red tail.
No way.
They actually have a red tail.
This is the.
They have a red tail.
So here we are at the pesky party. Place looks pretty nice, or the peida fish. And it looks like they got quite a good setup here. Really established. This must be one of the bigger, better ones. And they got the special fly. No way. Everything you need. The park supplied the bait, and it's actually a mix of almost like dog food pellets, and we used the hook here with a sort of chunky piece of foam to keep the dog pellet near the surface, the dog food pellet. We also use the bobber that you fill with the pellets, and when you cast out, it deploys the pellets around, which creates quite a feeding frenzy on the surface. The other technique the guys were using were you almost like dough balls with lots of corn and seeds, and they were just free lining that one, and that was pretty successful. I went ahead and used the bobber filled with the chum of dog pellets, and that proved to work pretty quickly. This mono has so much spring in it.
Mama?
Just get the net, Brace.
Oh, no! It's not!
Get the net, head in.
Net that fish, come on. Net him, get the net in there. Get it in the space. Get it in the space. Yep. Nice job.
Good job, that's a monster, huh? There you go, babe.
New mon. Mono heal.
That's it, you heal up. Here. 76?
Mama, I think you'll be born.
You can forget the GoPro, babe. He's gonna be fine.
Okay? Well, I hope he will.
That was pretty incredible. That fish actually bent the hook with its teeth. As if you look, they have human-like teeth in the top of the bottom of their jaw, and it actually bent that hook with its teeth.
Man, it's pretty
incredible.
See that
phrase? So we set off and started to look for another pesky party that may hold that monster pacu that we were looking for. Got some really nice red tail there. I was really hoping my son, Junior, would take the opportunity with me that day, but he was busy with a water park.
This is the rod I packed. It's a ugly stick. It's a 4-piece, 6'6", and it really fits in the suitcase nice. And it's pretty strong. I mean, it held up to a nice Pacu that we caught the other day. And then I have the BG 3500, topped off with like 14-pound braid. Really nice with the power handle on it.
So from my previous trip, I had one of the pellet flies, decided I was going to focus on that and use that exclusively. The park manager came out and kind of helped us out a little bit. He threw a couple buckets of pellets and created a crazy feeding frenzy. So my wife grabbed the camera and she started recording. And this is what we got out of it, the hookup and everything. But yep, we did it on the pellet fly.
You still got a lot of energy. This is your... Okay, come around. I'm gonna come backwards. You want his head to go in. Ready? Put his head in there. I'm gonna have to help you.
Wow.
Okay, what we're gonna do is put him on this thing, and I need you to get a photo, babe. Give me five. You did it, Fraser.
The biggest one I got.
With our time in Brazil drawing to an end and the weather changing, we knew it was time to go home. Our mission was accomplished, and we had achieved it. It was a great time. All right, guys. So if you like this video and you'd like to see us fishing and exploring some truly unique locations, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and like the video. And we'll catch up with you on the next one. Thanks for watching.